Hello, everybody. Once again, this is Gonzalo Vasquez, your Spanish teacher. And this is the easiest way to learn Spanish with NLS, the Natural Learning System. So let's do it. Today, we go to talk about the letter G, okay? Or la letra G in español, la letra G. La letra G. Okay. As you remember before, when we was studying for first time the alphabet, I told you that this has two sounds. G. The name of the letter is H. That has two sounds, g and h, h, depending in where or how you go to use it. What is the letter, the vowel that follow the letter h? Okay, so here is the examples. La g con la a, la letra g con la letra con la vowel a. Sounds g. Remember, the sound of the letter is g. If I put the a in front, will be g. G. Okay. Examples: gato. That's a cat. Gato. Gas. Gas. You know. Gas. Same gas in English. Gafas. Gafas, glasses, sunglasses or reading glasses, gafas, gafas. Gancho, gancho, can be many, cloth hanger, can be, this is a gancho, gancho, can be just a hook, okay, gancho. Gabriel. It's a man proper name. Gabriel Garcia Marquez. Everybody knows who he was. Okay. Once again. La letra G con la vocal A sounds ga. Ga. Gato. Gas. Gafas, gancho, Gabriel. Con la letra E, la letra G. Con la letra E, now come with the second sound. In this case, it's going to sound like J. Or it's going to sound like H in English. So, hey, see, actually, may, these two letters made the name of this one, hey. Examples, that's why I highlight this part over here, because it's changing the sound. Jeta. Somebody tell me, why, how come that you say jeta, is it? Jeta, remember, as I say before, Spanish is a very specific language. Jeta is to describe the mouth of an animal. Like the dog, you're not going to say in Spanish, we're not going to say, oh, la boca del perro. La boca es de las personas. The persons, the animals, jeta, la jeta del perro, la jeta del burro, la jeta de la vaca, okay, jeta, gemelo, gemelo, that's a twin, Hemir. Hemir. When you make it, a person, you know, the person is in pain or something else. You go to Hemir. General. Same thing in English. General. General. Same thing. Gente. Gente. People. Gente. Gente. When it's more than 2-3 persons. Gente. Esa gente. That group of people. Esa gente. Okay. La G con la I. Same sound. He. He. Gigante. That's a giant. Gigante. Gibraltar. Like the mounts over there in the Middle East. Gimnasio. A gym. Jibado. Hunch. Gilberto. Man's proper name. Once again, he, gigante, Gibraltar, gimnasio, jibado, oh, that person is jibado, está jibada, está jibado. Gilberto. Now, la G con la O, come back to the original sound of the letter G. G. Go. Go. Gondola. Is those little embarkations that you see, especially in Italy, those gondolas in Venice. You go, one of you, I bet you, you guys have been over there. The ones that have been over there, you know, already know what the gondola is. If not, the other ones probably in the movies, or one of these days, go to Italy and you go to see the gondola. Gota. It's a drop. Drop. Gota. Gomez. Gomez. It's the last name. Goma. Goma. It's like a gum, like a glue, like a chewing gum. Gobierno. It's a government. Goal. Everybody know. Goal for the football. Goal. Football soccer. Okay. Once again, he con la O. Go. Gondola, gota, Gomez, goma, gobierno, gol. La G con la U sounds gu, gu, guru. Same guru in English. Person who knows a lot. Guante, a glove. Gusano, it's a grove. Go on the grass and the, you know, the grubs. G-R-U-V-S. Guapo. Guapo is actually the description of guapo. It's actually a person who is strong. Don't, you know, it's a strong person. Okay? But in some countries, you go to hear that they say guapo is a person, nice looking man. Okay? So they describe, oh, it's guapo. Guayaba. Guayaba. That is guava fruit, tropical fruit. Once again, he con la u, gu, guru, guante, gusano, guapo, guayaba. Okay, let's do a little review here. So, the name of the letter is he. The primary sound is a g with, and this is for you to remember, with a ga, with o go, and with u gu, ga go gu. Acquire the sound of the j of jota in español or the h in English. With the letters E and letter E. He, he. Okay, remember, you have me here 24/7. So you will be able to review this video, have some fun, and learn the language the way it's supposed to be. Once again, this is the easiest way to learn Spanish with NLS, the Natural Learning System. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. You want to keep me over here? You want to keep Gonzalo teaching you? Subscribe to my channel. Make me any comments. Ask me questions. I will be more than glad to answer you. You can contact me anyway to my webpage at www.buenoletsdoit.com, or you can email me at gonzalo@buenoletsdoit.com. Once again, this is the easiest way to learn Spanish. Remember, I do design the type of the language depending if it's for your company, your industry, your profession. If you need it, I will be more than glad. Don't worry about, no matter where you are in the United States, I will be more than glad to help you in the continental US. Feel free to do it. Contact me. This is Let's Do It with Gonzalo Vasquez. Thanks for watching me, and I see you in the next video. Thank you.